In today's class, we are going to study power law transformations. We would see contrast stretching and we will see gray level splicing. So in power law transformation is actually where we are like multiplying the image pixel by some constant and we are raising the power of that pixel to some value of gamma. So the value of that constant and gamma would be the ones that would be majorly responsible for the transformations. So if I have fractional values of gamma, the transformation will behave like a log transformation. And I can have variations by varying that gamma. So it will map narrow range of dark input images into a wide range of output images. And it would be also true for higher values of input image. So if I'll have larger values of gamma where my gamma would be, you know, greater than 1, the transformation will behave like an inverse log transformation. So it will have just the opposite effect of what it had when my gamma was less than 1. And if C and gamma both of them become 1, then this will behave like an identity transformation. So we would be working with different values of gamma. We would be checking their effect on an input image and we would be implementing all these things in MATLAB. Next, we would see contrast stretching. So contrast stretching we require when I'll call a image as a good image if there would be a good contrast, meaning I am able to distinguish the details correctly and my foreground background are not correctly actually merged. The way you can see over here in my input image, the very famous pout image that is there available on MATLAB, then you see that there's no contrast in the image and everything looks so dark and so the details, the finer details are not so precisely visible. So the same thing happens that if I have a low contrast image, it could be due to bad or non-uniform illumination conditions, or it could be due to non-linearity in the acquisition devices. So what do we do in contrast stretching is that we remap a particular range of pixels to different levels such that my image is enhanced. So I might take some values from dark or near to black range and I may expand them or stretch them to a wider range of values that would increase the range and I would get a better contrast. So we would look at contrast stretching, we would look at thresholding where I keep a constant value and then I say less than this value I might go for 0 and higher than that value I might go for a white. So that would be thresholding and at the end we would be seeing intensity level slicing. So over here what we do is we select a particular band or a particular slice of intensity ranges and to those ranges we will assign a gray value. To the remaining ranges either we can assign them a low value or we can keep them as they were. So we would be taking a look at intensity based transformations, the intensity level splicing and all these transformations we would be performing in MATLAB. So I'll see you in class then.